جايين من كل مكان للصويرة زينة البلدان زورونا رجع فرحان
ברשות מראה ורבותיי עובדי פרמיד שמרוף השם, I would like to wish to all of you a Shabbat Shalom. The parasha of this week is so beautiful parasha, talk about now the new start of life of Yaakov Avinu when he went from his father-in-law that he was living in Haran now back to Eretz Israel. Now on his way to Eretz Israel, Yaakov Avinu alav shalom, the first thing he did, he sent some. Today we have fax, we have telephones. Today we have all kind of equipment to reach somebody. But at that time there was no letters, there was no email, there was nothing. At that time, just the information should go with through some messenger. So Yaakov Avinu sent some malachim, people to bring the message to Esav, his brother, and he told him, I'm coming back to my home after 20 years that I was not home. Now I'm back, I am married, I have children, I have wives, I have horses, I have cows, I have, I have everything. So the question is, why did Yaakov Avinu had to do that? I mean, Yaakov Avinu, he knows that his brother does love him. He knows that Esav is against him. All his wishes is just to kill him. And if he did not kill him up to now, because he thought that Yaakov, he was a homeless, he was nothing. But now if he hear that he's something, well, of course, Esav will be delighted to come and fight his brother and kill him. So really, why Yaakov did that? I mean, why Yaakov did, when he left Haran, when he left his father-in-law, he left quite, very quiet. No, he did not even told Laban that he's coming. And now that he's going to arrive to Israel, to his father in Hebron, why he has to send some messengers to Esav, his brother, to let him know what's going to happen, that he's coming and he's rich, and I don't understand why Yaakov, he had to do all this. Why? And besides this, you know, he revived the heat. He revived, all what happened between him and his brother. I mean, you know, sometimes when you do something bad to somebody, you do all your best that thing that happened, that bad thing happened, that should be forgotten. And now it's like Yaakov, you want to revive all the past. Look, Yaakov, all the reason why Yaakov, he ran away from his brother, because Yaakov knew that his brother, after all what he did to him, his brother is against him, he's very angry against him. And now, 20 years after, do you think what Yaakov did to his brother, can his brother forgive him? What he did to him? Never. So, why to do all this? This is the question that I would like to explain. Now, let's see the end of the last parasha. The end of last parasha, we have there a beautiful story. When Yaakov, he left his father-in-law, Laban, he ran away from him. And then, when Laban heard that his son-in-law, he ran away from him, and he took his girls, and he took all the family, so he ran after him and he catch him. And of course, Hashem, he came to Laban in the dream, and he told him, be careful if you hurt Yaakov. Be careful. I warn you, you should not hurt him. If you hurt him, I kill you. So Laban was afraid with that dream. And then he went to Yaakov, he made peace with him, and it was a separation. Okay, he told him, why you did that to me? Okay, at the end, they celebrate a big dinner. All night they were talking, and then the father, Laban, before he went, he kissed his children, he kissed his grandchildren, and he said hi to Yaakov, and he left. I do not understand. Laban, he was a big Russian. I don't understand why Laban, he did not learn from Yaakov to be a good person. Why Laban still, he was an idolatry? I mean, when I see the pictures of Tzadikim, I am impressed of them. I wish I could be like them. I promise you, you know, I feel so good when I am with big rabbis, good rabbis, honest rabbis. I feel so good, so, especially when I see pictures of my grandfather, pictures of other tzaddikim, Rabbi Akiva Iger, Maran Ravshach, or other tzaddikim. I feel good. I do not understand. I do not understand why Laban, for 20 years, he lived with Yaakov Abinu, and he did not change. He see the truth, the emet. He see that all the blessing that Laban he got, he had it only with the merit of Yaakov. Laban had only girls. He had no boys. And Yaakov only prayed for him. He told him, this year you will have boys. And he had boys. And he see the way Yaakov Abinu, he educates his children. Why not to learn from him? He sees his girls, Rachel, Leah, Bilhah, Zilpah, they were prophets. They were big tzadkaniyot. I mean, they knew the emet, they knew the truth. Why did not change? I mean, how it's possible? How it's possible? Well, my friend, Laban, he had a dream with Hashem. Hashem, you know with Hashem? You know what that means to have a dream with Hashem? And Hashem talk to you? Can you imagine? You change. And Laban, he had a dream of Hashem. And Hashem warned him, be careful. If you talk bad to Yaakov, I'll kill you. And he was afraid for him. He was afraid from that dream. So why you don't change? Why you don't change? My friend, the reason is that to change, it's not easy. It's easy to tell somebody you have to change. To change, it's a work. You have to change your nature. I mean, just somebody who is white, can he make himself to be brown? Less if he does something, but it's impossible. I mean, a black, he cannot be white, and a white, he cannot be black. Black is black, white is white. Chinese is Chinese. Can a white man say to himself, I want to change my look to be a Chinese, or to be a Japanese, or to be a black man? It's impossible. God created you black, so you are black. God created you to be white, so you are white. God created you to be Chinese, so you are Chinese. God created you to look like something. That's it. Can a monkey become a man? No. A monkey, okay, he sometimes he acts like a man, but he's a monkey. Monkey is a monkey. Can a cat become a dog? No. Can the cat change what the way she look, she the way she behave? Never. A cat, when she see a mouse, she run after him. You cannot change her. It's like that. It's a nature. It's a nature, you know. A lion is an animal. I mean, his nature is to kill. To hunt. He was born to hunt. His nature is to hunt and to kill. A person, his nature is to be what he wants to be. A dog, he was born with his nature. A cat, she was born with her nature. A black man, he was born black. A white man was born white. You cannot change them. It's this. White is white, black is black. A monkey is a monkey. A Rolls-Royce car. Can you make it a Renault? No. A Rolls-Royce car is a... That's the way she was created. She cannot be a Renault, or a Chevrolet, or a Fiat. A person, the way you educate him, is going to be. He can make his nature himself. Laban, he saw his sister Rivka. She was a big tzaddiket. He has beautiful girls, tzadkaniyot. He heard about Abraham Abinu. He heard about Yitzhak Abinu. He see Yaakov Abinu for 20 years. If he wanted to change, he could change. But he wanted to keep his nature. That's why Hashem gave us Kippur. Hashem give us Kippur that we can change our nature. We can change our way of life of all year. But it's up to us. Hashem give us all kinds of opportunity to come back to Him, to change. It's up to you. It's up to you. Look at Yaakov Abinu. Yaakov Abinu, when he left his father, before he went to Haran, to his uncle, to meet the girls, to marry them, he went to the yeshiva for 14 years. The question is why he needed to go to the yeshiva 14 years. He was already, when he went to the yeshiva, he was about 60 years old. And he stayed there 14 years. So when he left the yeshiva to go to Haran, it was 74 years. Then it's terrible. I mean, it's amazing. Why he had to go to the yeshiva another 14 years? You know why? Because Yaakov Abinu, he was thinking, here in my home, I know who is Esav, my brother. So I can deal with it. Because I am the home of Yitzhak. I am the house of Yitzhak. So Baruch Hashem, I have the influence, the good hashpah from my father, from my mother, from all the good people that they're here. So that will not affect me to get the influence from Esav, my brother. But now I'm going to go to Lavan. Lavan is a big Rasha. He has his own nature. His own nature is bad. And I have to stay with him. I have to face him. and I need to be more stronger in the Torah. I feel I am weak, he felt. I'm not so strong to go to Haran with them. I'm not enough heavyweight to fight Laban. So that's why Yaakov Abino, he wanted the yeshiva for another 14 years. Because that Laban, I don't know him. And maybe he will beat me. Maybe I will lose all my spiritual life that I got here in my house with my father. That was Yaakov Abino. Yaakov Abino, Alav Shalom. It's not, a lot of people, they think, yes, to go to live in Tel Aviv, to live in New York, in Manhattan, to live in China, to live, it's easy. For a Jew, nothing is easy. For a Jew, he has to be very strong, not to get the bad influence from others. From life today, life is not, the spiritual today, it's not easy to be a good Jew. There is Yetzirah everywhere. There is Yetzirah everywhere. The Baal Shem Tov said, it doesn't exist a Jew alone. Wherever I go, there is Hashem with him. Wherever I go, I know there is Hashem with me. But to know that but this is what the Baal Shem Tov said. It's beautiful what he said. But I have to tell you this. Wherever you go, there is Hashem. You're not alone. But it's up to you. It's you should be connected to him. It's like, whenever I call Hashem, he's available. Never Hashem, God forbid, is not available. Sometimes you call somebody, sometimes he's available, sometimes he's not available, sometimes he answers you, sometimes he don't want to answer you, maybe he's not there, but Hashem, always, wherever you are, he's there. The question is, are you there? Do you want to be with him? This is the question. So Yaakov Abinu Alav Shalom, he wanted to make sure that wherever he goes, there is Hashem there. And he is there as well. So that's why he went to the yeshiva for 14 years. To make sure that to be strong, enough to face. Because he knew that Lavan, he did not change. Since his sister Rivka married Yaakov, married Yitzhak, it's already more than 80 years, and Lavan, he did not change. He did not change. So that means that Lavan, he had a bad nature that he cannot change, that he don't want to change. He liked the way he lived. With all what he see, he don't want to change. Like this white man that is always white, that he cannot change. Like this monkey that is monkey, that is monkey, he cannot change. Because this is his nature. He made up, and you know, a man can change his nature. A man can change, but he wanted not to change. This is the Behera, this is the, each one has his own free will. The free will of Lava is to be what he is, bad. Like Esav, to be what he is, bad. That was Lavan. That's why Lavan, he did not change, even that he had a dream of Hashem, even that he was living for 20 years with his nephew, Yaakov, he did not change. He didn't want to change. That was Lavan. Now, Yaakov Abinu, my friend, when Yaakov Abinu wanted, he left his home, and now he wants to go home. Now he left his home in Haran, now he wants to go home to from where he belonged, where he was born, Hebron, to his father. It was very important for him to teach his children a lesson, a beautiful lesson. Hey children, you knew who was your grandfather? It was Laban. Now you're going to meet your the other grandfather, the tzaddik, the Yitzhak, the one who sacrificed himself for Hashem. And with him, you're going to see somebody strange. And maybe you will ask yourself, how that somebody did not change? Well, the answer is, he is like your grandfather Lavan. The same way that Lavan, his nature was not to change, because he didn't want to change, so Esav too. He respects his father. He's the son of Yitzhak. He's the grandson of Abraham Avinu. He's the brother, my brother, of Yaakov Avinu. He is your uncle, but he is. You will see what he is. That's why Yaakov Avinu, he sent some messenger to Esav, to meet Esav with him before he arrived home. He wanted his children to see that there is no difference between the godfather and the uncle. Because Yaakov Avinu didn't want them to have a surprise when they will meet Esav in the home of the grandfather Yitzhak. They will be surprised, they will be shocked to see what kind of man he is. So Yaakov Avinu was worried that he will get some bad influence from Esav. That's why he wanted his children to meet him before they arrive home. That was, yes, Yaakov Avinu took a big risk. But he relied, he had the emunah on Hashem. He said, Hashem, he was the one. He was the one who promised me all those kind of promises to protect me spiritually from Laban, to protect me from the hand of Esav. So, Hashem, I rely on you. You keep protecting me. If I have to do this act, a dangerous act, to meet my brother and to let him know that I am married, I have children, and I have everything, Baruch Hashem, it's very important that I make him feel angry against me so he can come to fight me, but I'm not afraid of him. You, Hashem, you protect me. It's very important for me that my children, the future Jews, the future nation, they will see my brother. And they should see that they have no family. The family is going to start now. I have no uncles, I have no grandfather. Beside my grandfather, beside my father Yitzhak, I have nobody. We have nobody. This is the way a star is born. From now, Hashem, I want to show my children that they are the stars. Now they are born. They have nobody, no grandfather from the side of the mother, not a brother, an uncle from the side of my father, Esav. No Lot, the grand uncle. You have nobody. There we have only Hashem. And the Torah. There is no cousin, there is nothing. So that he will not get bad influence from them. And that's what Yaakov Avinu did. Hashem, the same way that you send me protections from Laban, you send me protection from Esav. The question is, why, the same way that Hashem came to a dream to Lavan, why Hashem did not come to a dream to Esav to tell him, don't fight Yaakov? Why? From here, my friend, you understand how much Esav was more rasha than Lavan. Because Esav, Even when he saw the real angels, he was not afraid of them. So even if he will have a dream with Hashem, still he wouldn't care. That's why Hashem didn't give him the chance that he will come to his dream to frighten him. Don't fight Yaakov. We saw that Yaakov, when he left Laban, he did not pray to Hashem, Hashem protect me from Laban, my father-in-law. No, because Yaakov Avinu, he knew that Hashem can come to Laban in his dream and to tell him, don't do that, don't do any bad things to my Yaakov. That means that Esav was more Rasha than Laban. Laban, more or less, he believed in God. He believed in Hashem. Esav didn't believe in nothing. He believed only on pray. Free present. Pray for me and to have whatever I want, but I will not believe in the one who gave me. It was selfish. My friend, I would like to tell you a beautiful story. A beautiful story. There was this week, I went to Yerushalayim for the Brit Milah, and something happened that we had to leave very, very early, and I did not, it was Thursday, so I did not listen to the Kriyat HaTorah, on Monday and Thursday there is Sefer Torah, so because I did not have time, I said to myself, when the Brit Milah is going to be in Yerushalayim in a shul, in the synagogue. So when I arrive there, I pray. But there was too much traffic. Too much traffic. And unfortunately, the time we will arrive to Yerushalayim, they will finish the prayer, the tefillah. Maybe even they will finish the Brit Milah. So it's like we went to Yerushalayim for nothing. And I was very, very sad that we missed the Kriyat HaTorah, and I will miss even the Brit Milah, and I was sad. And Baruch Hashem, and a miracle happened. In my mind, I said to myself, "Well, if Hashem wants that I will attend the Brit Milah, thank you, Hashem. If you want that I will listen to Sefer Torah, thank you, Hashem." When we arrive there, we find out that they started, for no reason, they started the prayer very late. As soon as I put my feet in the synagogue, they started the Kriyat HaTorah. So I did not miss the Kriyat HaTorah, the Sefer Torah, and I did not miss the Brit Milah. It was incredible. You see, when you love Hashem, when you believe in Hashem, so Hashem help you. Hashem open you the doors. You will miss nothing. And you will have everything. God bless you. Have a good week. Thank you. حيم بنتو وقف لنا زي خوف.